Hi everybody, good evening.
Hello,
hi,
good evening.
Hi everybody, so hi. Thanks a lot for joining. Thank you very much for being here. How are you? So happy Thursday, how's everything? Nice. Good, ready?
Good. Ready.
Yeah, amazing. Yeah. So I'm super excited to see you guys. And also I'm very excited to see that we have a very good attendance. So thank you so much for that. That is just amazing. Let me stop presenting my screen. So because I wanna see you as well. Oh, there we go. Nice. So welcome everybody. My name is Julia. My name is Julia Sarceño. I'm going to be your facilitator for basic number one. I'm like very excited to see you. Well, algunos rostros ya los conozco. I already know some of your faces. But I also see que tenemos like new people here. So welcome, guys. How are you? ¿Cómo les va en su jueves? How is your Friday, your Thursday going?
Hi. New company.
A new company.
Yes.
What do you mean?
Hi.
Oh, are you in a new company?
Yes, teacher.
Oh. Did you change? Are you working in a new place?
Yes.
Wow, so congratulations. I'm happy to hear that.
Hey, Richard.
Hi.
Hi, Ignacio.
Good evening.
Good evening. Why did you change the company?
He changed his job.
By the way.
Ya está aquí el compañero también.
Please don't tell us about your job.
Eso estaba viendo que ya nos faltaba el compañero.
Yeah. No, yes. I'm super excited to see you guys. Gracias por ayudarme con la camarita. Danis, welcome back. Karina, welcome. Por ahí vi también a Dolores. Hi, Dolores. Good evening. Welcome to Basic 6. Claudia, hi. Good evening. How are you? Pedrina, me alegra verla. I'm so happy to see you. Hey, Guadalupe. How you doing? Hey. Hello. Moses. Hey, Moses. We did it. There we go. So here we are. Carlos. Hi, Carlos. I'm happy you're home. Norberto, no veo la cámara, Norberto. Hi, Norberto. Hi, Clary. Good evening. Hey, guys.
Hello.
Ahí está. There you go. Hi. How are you guys? I'm super excited to see you. Me alegra mucho que estén por acá. You know, que sigamos in this process, right? That we continue in basic number 6. Es el último nivel de básicos. Después de esto nos vamos directo a intermedio. So, to be honest with you, tengo como muchas expectativas about this course. Yo sé que hemos venido trabajando muy fuerte, que han tenido un salto enorme, that you're communicating super well. And obviously for this module, no va a ser la excepción, right? So I'm pretty sure that we will do an amazing job. Normally, at the beginning of classes, siempre tomamos asistencia y es como la actividad número uno, to take attendance at the beginning of the class and to take attendance again al finalizar la clase. So guys, voy a tomarles asistencia. Les pido me ayuden con su camarita, please, solo para asegurarnos you're there, it's your voice, y me regalan confirmación as well, para que nos quede la constancia, right, que pues sí son ustedes. Okay, give me one second. Solo, let me check it out. Okay, there we go. So, me ayudan con su camarita, por favor, un momento. Ana Delmi, Anita, ¿está por acá? No, not yet. Brian. No. Dani Anthony. Danis.
Danis present.
Thank you so much. Dolores.
Present.
Thank you. Miss, what do you prefer? Dolores or Sarai?
Cualquiera de los dos, no hay problema.
Oh, okay, okay. Eduardo.
Present.
Thank you, Eduardo, and welcome. Nice to meet you.
Good evening.
Good evening. Hello there. Creo que fue Brenda, right? I recognize your voice.
Hello, Brenda.
Hello. Hello, hello guys.
Hello, and hey. Thanks for joining. Guadalupe.
Danis, volviste.
Yeah.
new
welcome.
Company.
Yeah.
Just yeah. See them as I told you, they missed you.
Yeah,
okay. So, Jackie, no veo Jackie todavía. I don't see Jackie. Jocelyn, hello, hello, miss.
Present, teacher.
Here we go, hello. Thank you. Ignacio?
Teacher, present.
Thank you so much. Norbert? Gracias, present. Norbert. Thank you so much. Mr. Bonilla. Alex.
Present, teacher. Hi, everybody.
You. And your brother, Alex?
Here.
Oh, hello.
I am here.
Okay, no lo había visto. Thank you. Thank you so much. Marvin Lopez. Not here. Miriam. Clary.
Hello, miss. Present.
Amazing. Thank you. Moses?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ivan, Nelson Ivan?
Present, teacher.
Good evening. Thank you and welcome. Pedrina?
Teacher. Present, teacher.
Pedrina, we can make it. So you can definitely make it. Richard?
Present, teacher. Present.
Thank you so much. Hello. Great. Hello. Mabel?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Brenda? Brenda la acabo de escuchar. I just heard her voice. Carlos?
Present.
Thank you so much. Claudia?
Present, teacher.
Hello, miss. Good evening and welcome. And Karina?
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. All right. Okay, everybody, so thanks a lot, everybody, for coming super early, for joining today's class. Let me present my screen. Let me just get started with some general things. First, les agradezco por activarme la camarita, you know. You know that in online classes es bastante difícil, pues, tener este acercamiento o esta conexión. So I appreciate that you activate your camera, because in that way, los puedo ver, you know, you can see me. Y no me siento que me dejaron en visto al ver solamente la pantalla en negro. So thank you so much for that. Voy a comenzar con un par de generalidades. They are going to be in Spanish. Luego ya vamos a comenzar con el tema. Pero son algunas, you know, cosas que ya sabemos. Pero para que nos recordemos un poquito. So I have been asked que se los presente again. So eso es un poquito de my background, right? I'm not going to stop too much into this. porque pues ya me conocen algunos. You know me, you know. So I have been, the most relevant things I can mention are, one, I have been a teacher for maybe 10 years. So, y he trabajado en muchos lugares. I have worked in a lot of places. Okay. So I'm going to be with you. Voy a estar con ustedes este módulo and hopefully vamos a, voy a ayudarles, right, a llegar hasta donde ustedes necesitan to be in intermediate number one. So eso es como mi objetivo personal, ayudarlos, encaminarlos, ayudarle a encontrar la forma más fácil para que sus habilidades mejoren, and you can be there, you can be ready for that. Algunos requerimientos personales. Ok, to get started, les indicaba por ahí que al ingresar y escribamos nuestro nombre completo, esto es un requisito de INSAPORT. So, si tienen un nombre o un apellido, it's fine, pero de lo contrario sí les pido que hagamos el cambio, right, a nombre completo según Dewey. So, si son dos nombres, dos apellidos o tres nombres, que aparezca tal cual para que en la lista de asistencia no me lo vayan a afectar después. Bueno, de hecho veo que la mayoría me entró con el nombre completo. So, thank you so much for that. Number two. En el caso de oyentes, vamos a agregar la palabra oyente, right, al final de su nombre, después. Tengo cuatro oyentes, entiendo que los compañeros de administración más o menos les comentaron que es un oyente, or why, porque me le iban a poner esta palabrita. Veo, por ejemplo, que Carlos ya me le puso oyente, gracias Carlos, thank you so much. Tenemos todas las responsabilidades, right, solo que por cuestiones de administración. Vamos a agregarle esta palabrita. Brenda, si me ayuda también, porfa. So, vamos a agregarle la palabrita oyente al final. Karina, also. And, me falta alguien. I'm gonna check it in a second. So, pretty much that's it. La tercera es la cámara encendida durante toda la sesión o tanto como sea posible, as much as possible. A veces por nuestra conexión de internet, pues él está como súper lento, no nos deja trabajar, etcétera. Pero en la medida que podamos, right, try to keep your camera on, porque de esa forma los podemos ver, nos pueden ver y verbal expression en ese punto es bien importante, right, para ver cómo pronuncia, cómo dice algo, si piensa mucho y para que no haya como tanto silencio, right. La siguiente es minimizar el sonido ambiente lo más posible. Bueno, eso se refiere más que todo a la televisión. Si tiene la televisión muy alta, solo yo no le bajo un poquito, porfa. O pues si hay una gran un pachangón en la casa, y you know, que pueda buscar como una esquinita, a place que no esté como muy ruidoso, para que podamos escuchar y participar, right? Y la más importante de todas, participación activa. This is not like me talking. La idea no es que yo hable durante las dos horas, okay? The idea is that you talk, that you participate, that you develop your abilities. Que usted escuche al compañero y le conteste. Que escuche, entienda, and you are able to answer lo que le esté preguntando, right? So your participation is super important. And a los chicos que se nos acaban de incorporar, I can tell you, el grupo es super genial, el grupo es super, super cool. Se ayudan mucho, they help each other a lot, you know, and so espero que puedan llevarse súper bien y sobre todo pues que no tengan pena, you know, si hay algo que no lo sabemos, you know, nadie va a hacer bullying, nadie se va a poner a burlar or anything, we don't really do that, sino al contrario, nos ayudamos, si no sabemos cómo decir algo, preguntamos, nos ayudamos, and para, you know, poder avanzar a little bit y poder mejorar, right? So, esos son parte de los requirements con respecto a la clase. Now, I have just some more. Y estos son bien importantes. These are very, very important. So, la primera. Y les voy a pedir su ayuda, pero enorme con esto. Nuestra asistencia tiene que ser el 100%. When I say 100% es que no hay permisos, you know, there are not, you know, absence or anything. INSAPORT no está permitiendo ahorita ninguna asistencia ni por enfermedad ni por anything. So, si les pido su ayuda enorme, si se siente mal, si tiene que salir, you know, or something is going on, me avisa, you know, you let me know, like, teacher, voy a estar escuchando, I'm going to be listening, pero sí les pido que, you know, que estemos acá, right, that we are present. Y como vamos a practicar más speaking, significa que el listening también va a ser como más exigido, and obviously, si usted está escuchando, pues está entrenando y desarrollando su habilidad de listening, así que please, help me with this, no podemos faltar, right, ningún día. So, a ninguna clase. Okay, just to make sure. So, la asistencia no solamente es estar presente, sino también cumplir con la clase. Esa es otra cosita. Nuestra clase o el control de clase se toma por minuto de conexión. Significa que si usted se conecta 30 minutos tarde, esos 30 minutos se le descuentan. Aunque estuvo bien participativa, you know, and everything, no solo es me voy a conectar 10 minutos y me salgo. You know, no se toma así, sino que nos piden un control de minuto a minuto, like, cuánto hemos estado. So, por eso es que a veces les escribimos, Luke, conéctese, Luke, lo esperamos. No es por molestarlos, you know, por incomodarlos or anything, sino que porque InSupport es estricto. Y sabemos que la beca es totalmente pagada por ellos. Más o menos una clase de inglés se ha tomado, valen entre $80 a $90, and this is like totally free for you. Y la beca la tienen siempre y cuando cumplamos con los dos requisitos importantes que son, number one, más de, la asistencia, y la segunda es más de 8 como nota, right, de módulo. So, that's why, les pido su ayuda conectándonos a tiempo y pues estando en todas las clases, right. La asistencia la tomamos, like, normally 3 veces, al inicio, como lo hicimos ahora, luego a las 8 y al finalizar la clase nuevamente se toma como confirmación, right, that you were here, o si alguien pues tuvo un atraso, se conectó un par de minutitos, 5 minutitos, pues por eso tomamos la asistencia a ti en la escuela. Se tomará como válido el escuchar el participante decir present, presente, hello, I mean, para escuchar que son ustedes, right? Y tener la cámara encendida. This is why, si le pedimos el ayuda con la camarita. Let me see what else. Tenemos sesiones one-on-one, las cuales son 10 minutos al finalizar la clase. Para este módulo vamos a hacer un pequeño cambio con las sesiones one-on-one. And at the end, you know, of the class, yo normalmente les digo a quién le toca la sesión one-on-one para que se quede un par de minutitos después. So, vamos a hacerlo como práctica, right? Les voy a dar un tema y vamos a hacer como una mini presentation at the end para que vayamos practicando un poco más, para que vayamos saliendo de dudas, you know, y pues tengamos también esa oportunidad de escucharlos y corregirlos o ver si hay algo que mejorar, solo podemos aprovechar this way. Nuevamente acá está, permisos no están disponibles. Lastimosamente acá sí se sale un poquito de nuestras manos, you know, but no hay ningún tipo de permisos. I mean, no está en nuestras manos dar permisos. No sé si tienen preguntas. I'm sorry que estoy hablando un poquito ahora. Ya voy a terminar para que ustedes puedan empezar a hablar. But no sé si tienen dudas con esto. Yes, yes.
Básicamente una solicitud para ver, dígame, si es posible.
Claro.
Los 10 minutos que nos corresponden, ¿usted nos los puede dar por anticipado y no anunciarlos nada más en el momento? Como para que uno se pueda programar.
Oh, sure. De hecho, les puedo compartir. I can share with you the program. Mm-hmm.
Ok.
Ya se los voy a compartir. I'm going to share that with you. For example, el día de ahora, today. Déjame un segundo. No, no lo tengo en la mano. Ya se los comparto. Deme unos segunditos, solo abro el thing. But yes. Well, de hecho, ahora tenemos con Anita, pero no sé si Ana ya está acá. Anita. I don't see her. Okay. But today is with Anna. I'm going to check it out later. Okay. So, but yes, thank you so much. Y super válido. Ya se lo voy a compartir para que ustedes sepan que día les toca también. Mm-hmm. That would be super cool. All right. Okie dokie. Now, con respecto a las tareas y las evaluaciones, les mencioné que necesitamos como nota mínima un 80%, right? Because es como el promedio final de tareas y de evaluaciones para completar el curso satisfactoriamente. Now, las tareas están en la plataforma. La mayoría tiene acceso a la plataforma. Chicos, los que se nos acaban de incorporar al grupo, me confirman si ya les compartieron el acceso, si entraron, si ya lo revisaron o todavía no.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
teacher.
Okay. So, en la plataforma ya tienen de hecho posteadas todas las actividades. Ustedes pueden avanzar cuanto puedan, right? As much as you can. Si usted dice, este fin de semana voy a completar dos unidades, por ejemplo, una unidad, siéntase con toda la libertad de hacerlo. No hay ningún problema y así nos quedamos solamente con la práctica oral, right? La práctica de listening y la práctica oral durante la clase. So, Now, las tareas, bueno, están acá. Normalmente hacemos una por día. Por ejemplo, ahora terminamos sesión 1, terminamos la tarea 1, para que no se nos acumule, right? Todas las tareas de los temas están ya cubiertos, tienen que estar completadas antes del viernes. Well, en nuestro caso, ya que comenzamos el día jueves, significa que el próximo jueves tendría que ya estar completo toda la unidad número 1. But in this case, como tenemos el fin de semana, sí les voy a pedir que avancemos durante el fin de semana, right? Para que no sea después más difícil o yo sé que el trabajo a veces nos consume. Y para evitar eso, avancemos el fin de semana, right? Tenemos como fecha límite, tenemos dos evaluaciones bien grandes, digamos. El primero es un midterm, lo completamos en la semana 2. Acá dice septiembre 1st, pero manejémoslo como... El midterm es en la semana 2 y el final exam es al finalizar. Y ahí les aparece, right? Ahí desaparece en la plataforma. Now, el manual puede ser descargado en la plataforma. Los compañeros de administración, de hecho, el día de ahora, vi que les estaban compartiendo ya el manual. Usted lo puede descargar. También está en la plataforma. Y algo importante es que no usamos material de terceros. So, normalmente no utilizamos YouTube videos o algo que no sea propio de eSupport, you know, por derechos reservados, right? Pretty much, eso es con respecto a las tareas y evaluaciones. Al finalizar la clase, les voy a más o menos mostrar cómo se ve por si no han entrado y a dónde van a encontrar las tareas también, cuál es la tarea del día de ahora. Con respecto a Zoom, yo creo que la mayoría ha trabajado con Zoom alguna vez. So, in general, tenemos el botón de mute. Cuando ustedes entran, automáticamente el programa los pone en mute. O ustedes se pueden mutear también. Then you have the camera button, that is the second one. Tenemos los chat. El chat puede ser general o usted puede escribir o escoger a quién le quiere escribir. Pueden ser privados too. Tenemos los breakout rooms que los vamos a utilizar. And let me explain por qué los breakout rooms son importantes. Los breakout rooms son como estos grupos más pequeñitos que hacemos para que practiquen. And it's important porque inglés es un idioma. So, ¿cómo aprendo un idioma? Pretty much es socializando. Si no lo practico, o digo, me lo voy a memorizar, lo voy a practicar conmigo, no es lo mismo que practicar con otra persona y que esa persona me entienda lo que yo quiero decir, right? So, la idea de los breakout rooms es que usted vaya, que escuche a alguien, y sobre todo que alguien más lo escucha a usted y le entienda lo que está queriendo decir. So that is the idea. And this is why es importante que los utilicemos al máximo. Y la última que es el botón de Ask for Help, que es si tienen dudas, if you have any question, le dan clic ahí. Y cuando estamos en los breakout rooms, es como si me llaman, you know. And I go there. So, eso es con respecto a Zoom. Ya lo vamos a utilizar, así que no worries about them. Y creo que todos los hemos utilizado. ¿Alguien no ha utilizado Zoom before? Nelson, Karina, Dolores. ¿Alguna vez han utilizado breakout rooms? ¿Han estado como en grupos más pequeños?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Uy, entonces estamos súper bien. We are good. We are good, good, good. Okay. Nice. Questions sobre lo que he mencionado, que es bastante. Pero, chicos, ¿ustedes ya habían estado con nosotros o es la primera vez? los módulos anteriores los estudiaron con inglés corporativo.
Yes, the two before I started.
Oh, okay. So no es nada nuevo what I'm saying. Okay. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Yes.
I am seeing for new classmates.
De hecho, son más. We got more.
Only four, I see.
Yeah, we got a couple more. Okay. Creo que me faltan cuatro. I'm missing four people. Okay. Okay, guys. So, antes de iniciar, before getting started, because I think it's important to, ya mencioné como parte de lo que InSupport nos pide, some of the things that we have to comply, pero antes de get started, I consider this part is very important, y quiero hacer algo con ustedes. Do you know the meaning of commitment? ¿Saben qué es un commitment? ¿Han visto esa palabra antes? Have you seen the word before?
No.
Okay, no worries. Let me explain to you. Commitment es un compromiso, yeah? So the word commitment means compromiso. What I want you to do, lo que quiero que ahorita piensen is the following. Este es el último nivel de básico. Next module, van para intermedio. Yo tengo las expectativas that I want y a dónde quiero que ustedes lleguen, you know? What I want you to do al finalizar este módulo. But what I want you to do right now is the following. Quiero que piensen en un compromiso personal, no conmigo, no con el programa, no con la clase, sino something that you say, okay, este módulo voy a hacer esto, pero algo que sea verdad, algo que sea doable. Tampoco me digan voy a aprender 20 palabras al día, because that's impossible, you know. Estamos hablando de, oh my God, miles de palabras en el módulo. Pero algo que usted diga, I'm gonna do it every single day religiosamente from this day, hasta el finalizar el módulo, and that by the end of the module, you say, oh, lo logré, you know, I did it. So pueden ser, I don't know, me voy a aprender 10 palabras a la semana, pero que lo realmente lo haga, o me voy a aprender los verbos en presente, pasado y pasado participio, 5 verbos a la semana, 3, o un verbo diario, I don't know. Think about something, y quiero que los escriban in the chat, right? O me voy a conectar todos los días a la hora, you know. But every day, the idea is to do it. O no voy a faltar a clases. So, every day, you gotta do it. Or, I don't know, voy a aprenderme una canción, for example, in English, every week. So, whatever your objective, whatever your commitment, la idea es que usted se lo proponga y lo logremos al finalizar el módulo, right? So, déjenmelos en el chat, please. Piénsenlo, I will give you like 2 minutes, think about it, y cuando ya lo tengan, you write it in the chat. So the idea is that es un personal commitment, es un, you know, un compromiso con ustedes, that you say, nombre este módulo, el módulo anterior no participé casi, este sí, you know, I'm gonna speak more. No importa si me da pena, me da miedo, you know, I'm gonna participate more. So write it down. I'll give you I'll give you 1 minute. No hay mucho que pensar. I'll give you 1 minute. Think about it, guys, and leave it in the chat. Me lo dejan en el chat, please.
Teacher, sorry.
Oh, it's okay. Tell me.
You're wearing glasses?
I wear glasses. I wear glasses. Que no me los pongo con otra cosa. Yeah. But I have to wear them.
Yeah, yeah. Like me.
Yeah. No, I realized today. Me di cuenta que tengo más. Ya me incrementó. So, anyways.
A little. Okay.
Yeah. So that's bad.
It's cool.
Now it's bad. It's bad. I don't like it, but anyways. All
right.
Dancing.
Hi, Richard.
Dancing, Dan.
No.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so let me just take a look here. Oh, thank you guys. Thank you so much for writing your commitment. I see, for example, memorizar 10 verbos a la semana. Okay, cool, cool, cool. Serían dos verbos diarios. I'm gonna review classes. Okay.
Richard, really?
Okay. Okay, be punctual. One verb. Oh, one verb in present, past, and past participle every day. Okay, cinco a la semana. Who? Mm-hmm. Verbs, present, past, and past participle. One daily. Okay, one verb daily. Then verbs a week.
Brenda.
Brenda says pay attention. Ooh. I need to see that, Brenda. Okay. I need to see that. No, but that's okay. So remember, this is a personal commitment. Es un compromiso con ustedes. And the idea is that at the end of the module, por cierto, la clase queda grabada. So we are going to review, okay? And we are going to say like, hey, sí hice esto. I did that, right? So lo logré. I could do it. Si no lo quieren postear, you know, open for everybody, en el chat pueden, you know, seleccionar and you select me. So that's okay. Me faltan algunos. I'm missing some. Think about it carefully. Y me lo escriben, please. And you leave it here. You leave it right there. I'm going to learn fine words. Okay. Okay. I have commitment. I need to set it to verbs daily. Okay. Two verbs. Okay. So, also with listening, puede ser, I'm going to watch a movie. I'm going to... Two new words every day. I'm gonna learn five words. Oh, wow, Pedrina, your commitment is amazing. Five words every day. Okay. Ooh. That's a lot. Okay, cool, but I like it. I like it, very, very nice. Okay, guys, so continue leaving your commitment here. Y recuérdense de cuál fue like your personal commitment so we can check it later by the end of the session. Okay, let me just move on and now let's get started. So, as I said before, normally this no se trata de que yo voy a hablar or anything. On the opposite, es que ustedes van a hablar. So, I have some questions for you. Vamos a discutir. We are going to discuss a couple of questions, right? So, oh, Nelson, thank you so much. So, 8 p.m. Y si no le voy a llamar, you know, Nelson, what's going on? Okay. Dolores has a study in practice. Okay. Nice, nice, nice. So, let's take a look at the following here. I have five questions for you that we are going to discuss. No sé si han practicado estos días, you know, this week. Y si no, pues, let's go ahead and let's practice this back. Number one says, what do you do in your free time? A very easy question. Number two, how do you relax when you're stressed out? So what do you do when you feel under stress? Do you scream? Do you count to 10? What do you do? Do you punch something? Do you hit the wall? What do you do? Three, do you prefer to be alone? Or around people, what is better for you? ¿Cuál es mejor? ¿Estar solos? You know, to be alone or around people with your family, with your friends? Why? Why do you prefer to be alone? Or why do you prefer to be with people? Number four, if you have a day off, school, or a day off, remember that a day off es un día libre. If you have a day off, school or work, do you sleep in late? ¿Se levantan tarde? Do you sleep in late? Or do you wake up early? Or what do you do, right? And number five, what are some things that you consider to be a waste of time? ¿Qué es algo que es una pérdida de tiempo? What do you consider that is a waste of time?
Watch the series.
Personally, I consider that a waste of time is Facebook, pero aún así lo hago. So this is something that I consider to be a waste of time, una pérdida de tiempo. What about in your case? What is something that is a waste of time? I think that aprender otro idioma no es una pérdida de tiempo. I don't think it's a waste of time. On the opposite, you know, it helps a lot. So let's get started, all right? But to get started, I want you to speak as much as possible, get familiar with the questions. Guadalupe says, I'm going to try to speak a little more in classes. Nice, Guadalupe, I want to see that. Definitely, that's cool. So I want you to take a picture, please. Tomemos una fotito. Let's take a picture of this and let's get started with the practice. So, okay, so allow me just a second. Les voy a pedir que nos unamos a los grupos. Say hello, you know, say nice to meet you. Pueden hablar un poquito de ustedes, right? But since it is basic six, lo único que les voy a pedir es, de ser posible, reduzcan el español hasta lo, you know, lo menos que puedan. And try to keep it English, right? Yo sé que a veces estamos en los grupos and it's like, ay, la teacher me saca, hablemos español. But the idea is to speak. Así que, guys, let's go, let's practice. Activen la camarita también para que lo vean los compañeros, you know. So it's definitely better. And tienen 5 minutos. You got 5 minutes to discuss the questions. 5, 7 minutes. Tanto como puedan. Speak as much as you can, guys. And try to keep it English. So let's do it. Go, 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 go. Me confirman si todos logran entrar. Si ven la invitación, let me know.
El bendito libro. No me acordaba.
¿Ha mandado libro?
Sí. Es que creo que te
guys.
Te uniste después de que ella lo mandó.
On the group.
Hello, hello.
Teacher.
Yes.
We have a... We need the machine.
Oh, yes, sure. I just checked in WhatsApp. Give me 1 second. Let me share this with you. Okay, there you go.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Now we took the screenshot.
Nice, nice. So okay. You can get started. The idea is only to like discuss them, say your opinion, answer the questions, right? And if you find new vocabulary, so you can write it down. Mm-hmm.
Okay, teacher. Well, the first question, Eduardo, what do you do on your free time?
In my free time, I usually watch TV or maybe read something, a book maybe.
Oh, cool.
Okay, voy a decir la dos. Nelson, how do you relax when you are stressed?
Drink a coffee. We eat bread.
Okay.
Good. Okay. Who asked me?
Nelson, can ask number three.
Have a day off, or work. For example, the Saturday or Monday is your day off. Sleep online.
Sería the day Saturday.
Okay.
They
I get out.
I am travel in San Salvador City.
Oh, okay.
The shopping.
Excellent. In my case, grab or 5 a.m. or room or watching TV or play. You, Pedrina?
No.
Sleep and lay?
No. No.
Get up?
No, por el momento, por no.
We are so good that you can do it together.
I like to watch TV because I think watch the series is more time. Entonces, I like to travel the beach for lunch is mejor, is best.
Best, yes. Best. What are something that you consider to be a waste of time?
Why?
Number five. What are something that you consider to be a waste of time?
Eso es como, pérdida de tiempo. I think, y lo digo con todo respeto, I don't like play to videojuegos. I don't like.
No, no, yes.
I like.
I do not.
Yeah. In my case, is waste of time in social media, for example, Facebook or
TikTok.
No, I don't like. No. Now, you, Norberto.
For me,
yes,
is como decirle, relax o see social red,
yeah.
Like to check Facebook, like Facebook, Instagram, social networks.
Yeah, no.
No, it's very necessary.
Mm-hmm. No. So for you, that is a waste of time, or it is relaxing. ¿Cuál de las dos? Sorry.
Well, first time.
A waste of time.
Yeah.
Una pérdida de tiempo.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Do you check Facebook?
No. No, it's frequently.
Okay.
No.
How often? How often do you check Facebook? Once an hour, every day, every week? How often?
1-3 hours.
Once every 3 hours?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Pedrina, do you have Facebook?
No frequent.
Okay. So you don't check it often. All right. Alex, what about you?
I don't like play the video games.
Okay. What about social network? Do you check Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok? Check social networks? Really?
Yes, because for I consider to be what sign. It's really.
Oh, it is a waste of time. Do you have TikTok?
Yes, I have TikTok.
What?
Es una malísima inversión de tiempo.
Do you make TikToks?
Yes. Yeah.
Guys, have you ever made a TikTok?
I watch TikTok.
Watch TikTok?
Very, very bad.
No.
Okay, but it's a waste of time. I watch TikTok videos, but in Facebook or in YouTube, but I don't have TikTok. I don't have an account. Pedrina, no. Have you ever made a TikTok video? ¿Alguna vez ha hecho un video? Have you made a TikTok video? No?
No.
But you seen the videos?
Yes, I'm... Yo he hecho videos.
What? Videos you made a video.
Yes, I made a video.
What?
I have one video. Viral video.
No.
Oh.
What? What are you making in the video? What is the video about?
No, es que en inglés no lo puedo decir.
Try.
Es como de una party.
Try. Aquí le ayudamos. So the video is about a party.
My video is the party, the Rockefeller's. They're thinking the people.
Because
como las personas piensan que es una fiesta de rockeros.
Yes.
Oh, a rock party. Yes. Okay.
Okay, pero because no es así como las personas creen.
Okay. So, how many views does your video have?
45,000
views. No.
Really?
48 hours.
No, really? I have a question for you. Does TikTok give you money?
No.
Okay.
No.
Wow. 45,000 views in 48 hours.
Yes.
So
yes.
Your video went viral.
The people like the video. I don't know because.
Wow. Okay. Oh my goodness. Guys, let's make some TikTok videos. Yeah. Okay. I have no idea. Wow. Okay.
I am a trailer to your video, the next video.
Hey, share your video.
Yes.
Yeah. Share your video, Alex. Wow. I didn't know. Norbert, have you ever made a video?
What?
No, teacher.
No, but do you have TikTok? Do you have an account?
No.
You don't have. But do you watch TikTok videos? No.
No.
You don't like them? You don't find them interesting? Why not?
Excuse me?
Why? Why you don't like TikTok?
Quizás porque no le puse mucha atención a la aplicación.
Oh, okay. Because you have not paid attention. Okay. You can say, I have not paid attention. Se lo escribo en el chat. Let me write it there. So, I have not paid attention to it. Oh, no es interesante. It is not interesting for me. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So, I have not paid attention to it. No le puse atención, right? Oh, okay. Interesting and good to know. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, but I want to see Alex's video. I really want to see his video, though. Okay. Okay, guys. Vamos a regresar. Let's go back to the main session. Nice talking to you.
Okay. Me ha dicho que le gustan algunas.
Algunas.
Creo que ya están. Uh-huh.
Hello. Yes. Hi there.
Hello, teachers.
Thanks a lot for joining. Oh, I'm happy. I'm happy to hear you were practicing. So that you were practicing
here.
Nice. Okay, everybody. So thanks a lot for coming back. Gracias por regresar. I was listening to some of your participation, and that was amazing. Very interesting, though. Y creo que Alex nos va a comentar ya saca Alex. So Alex, tell us about your video. I found it very interesting. I didn't know.
I have a video TikTok app, the Party Rocker. My video is viral video for have 45,000 views. So in 48 hours.
That's like incredible. Guys, do you have TikTok? Do you have a TikTok account? We were talking about waste of time, the activities that are a waste of time. So Alex mentioned that TikTok is a waste of time, but he has a viral video. Can you believe it? So 45 views in 48 hours. So suddenly, next module, Alex will be like, se va a convertir en TikToker. So he will be the next TikToker from El Salvador. Wow, that's amazing. Okay.
I need, Danny?
No. No, Richard.
I don't know.
No, Richard.
Okay. So tell me a little bit about this. Guys, I want you to tell me three activities that you do in your free time. Vamos a hacerlo como súper rapidito. Okay, so no quiero que lo piense mucho. Just tell me your answer. Let me select some of you. And really quick, sin pensarlo, díganme tres actividades súper fast. Carlos, tell me three activities you do in your free time. Three.
Okay, in my free time, I walk the soccer match.
Mm-hmm.
I play soccer match.
Mm-hmm.
And I play with my daughter.
Oh, amazing. I like it. Guadalupe, what do you do when you are stressed out? Really quick, tell me three things. Dígame tres. Tell me three.
I like to watch the movie.
Uh-huh.
Send music.
Mm-hmm.
And in sleep.
Okay, very good. There we go. Eduardo, Eduardo, tell me three things. What do you do when you are stressed out? Lo más rápido que pueda, the fastest you can. What do you do when you are stressed out?
Just a walk, maybe watch TV, and maybe take a shower to forget everything.
Oh, okay. And take a shower. That's okay. Cool, cool, cool. Three, do you prefer to be alone or around people? Let me select next person. Norbert, alone or with people? And why? Tell me why. Really quick.
For me, teacher, alone.
Why? Go, Norbert, go.
Because ¿cómo decir? Este.
Say it in Spanish. Ellos le ayudan, no se preocupe.
Okay, for practice or for the world in my house.
So you prefer to be alone?
Yes, alone.
Okay.
¿Cómo decir? Mm-hmm. Algunos momentos.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
In my house or in a play or a space.
Okay.
The lead.
Okay, the, so you prefer to be alone? Okay, you prefer to be alone and you prefer to be in your house?
Yes, in my house.
Okay, where you live. Mm-hmm. Okay, okay, got it. That's okay, that's totally fine. Let me go with Renee. Renee, alone or with people and why?
When I like to be alone.
Why?
I don't know, because it's, I consider myself
a lone wolf.
Yes, but I prefer, for example, I prefer stay in my house alone, and for example, in my free time, I play the trombone. I practice.
Yes. Okay.
I don't like to talk with other person. It's very raro.
It's strange.
It's very strange.
Okay.
When I talk with other person.
Oh, okay. Interesting. So, who likes to be with people? Guys, entonces, ¿a quién le gusta estar rodeado de personas? Who likes to be with people? Creo que es más fácil that way. Okay. Really? Why?
Teacher.
Jocelyn? I think it was Jocelyn.
Yes, but Ignacio le estaba hablando.
Oh, let me listen to you and then I go with Ignacio. I'm okay. Yeah, I'm okay with it.
Yes, I prefer around with my family. My family is the biggest. Estamos acostumbrados.
We are used to.
We are used to. Together with my family.
Okay. Cool. That's very interesting because my family is big too. So I'm like with 10 people all the time. Okay. Cool. Ignacio, tell us. Alone? No, with people. You say why?
Sorry, but I want to participate for to say our the group depend on the time.
Oh, for you example, mean number four? Question four.
Question four.
Or what question do you mean?
Three.
Yeah, no, the question four.
Four, right? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I like the to use my time in the sleep in my hamaca, you know.
So oh, you sleep in the hammock. Yeah. Okay, so you sleep in the hammock. All right.
Yeah, relax and the two time energy. I don't.
Oh, okay. No, but that's very cool. Let me write it down. That's a hammock. All right. So you prefer to sleep in a hammock. Yeah. Okay. Now, guys, what about the last one? What are some things that you consider a waste of time? Can you tell me 5 things that are a waste of time? Cosas que son un gasto de tiempo innecesario. Number one, I have to put TikTok. Okay. What comes to your mind? What else?
Facebook.
Okay.
For social media in general.
Social media in general. All right.
Not study. Sleep too much.
Sleep too much. Mm-hmm.
Play video games, teacher.
Play video games, okay.
No.
Sorry.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, can you repeat that, Richard?
Go necessary.
Going necessary. Yes. Go out.
What?
Como salir a parrandear.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Oh,
yes,
okay. Yes. Go out more than necessary.
In necessidad.
Because the duty.
Okay. Meet the nation.
Go out more than necessary. Okay. No, but that's true. So go out more than necessary. Okay. 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 ¿Qué más? What else? What is a waste of time for you guys? Es una pérdida de tiempo. Yes?
For example, if you can out your home early morning,
okay.
You can don't be a waste time in the traffic.
A waste of time. I mean, yes, traffic is a waste of time. But the thing is that traffic no lo podemos controlar, you know. Pero el tiempo de Facebook, sí. However, we don't do it. So that is the point. Okay. So video games, creo que alguien mencionó antes series, como ver series de televisión, right? Guys, alguien no, nadie mencionó Betty la Fea. That's a waste of time. Don't watch novelas, guys. Don't watch soap operas. And if you watch soap operas and series, hagámoslo en inglés. Do it in English. So yes. In that way, están haciendo algo positivo al mismo tiempo que enjoyment, right? Cool. Let's continue with this. So let's take a look at the question I have for you. Question one says, what are your abilities or strengths? Hablemos un poquito de strength. We do have abilities. Todos tenemos habilidades. Probably no las han descubierto. But everybody has abilities. Also, está la palabra strength, right? Strength, la fortaleza. Algo que es de ustedes, you know? Something that belongs to you, that is part of your personality. So, tell me yes or no for the following. What are your abilities? Guys, I can sing quite well. Who can sing very well?
Yes.
Danny's? Okay. Yes. Guys, who can sing? I know. Guru. Okay, who can sing? Dolores, Claudia, can you sing very well? Can anybody sing, Karina?
No, I can't.
You can't? Moses, can you sing?
No, teacher.
Now, Brenda. No, Brenda can dance, I remember. What about singing? Guys, do we have a singer, Nelson? Nobody? Oh, so bad. Okay, so I guess, really, nobody. Okay, I will be able to speak English well after this course? Yes or no? What do you think?
Yes.
Well, yes. Espero que sí, guys. Of course, yes. Of course. So, me ganitas, guys. Let's do it. I could play a sport well when I was younger, but not anymore. Is that a yes or a no? I could play a sport well when I was younger. No?
No.
Anybody? ¿Alguien podía? ¿Alguien era muy bueno jugando? No. I could play a sport when I was younger? No?
I don't have play nobody deeper.
Nothing? No sports at all?
Nothing.
Oh, okay, interesting.
Right now.
Yes,
right now.
Sabrina.
Yes, softball.
Oh, nice. Okay. Yes. Well, did you play well?
Mucha práctica tenía cuando.
When you were younger.
Pinchadora.
Ah, sí. When I was younger.
But not anymore.
Pedrina, what was your position? A pitcher? A catcher?
A catcher.
You were a catcher. Wow. I was a catcher too. Pero no me gustaba. I didn't like it. Okay. I didn't like it. It was very dangerous. Okay. Nice. Pedrina was a good one. She was good with sports. Okay. Next one.
Karina. Quería decir algo.
No, but Karina, I think Karina said she didn't, right, Karina?
No, I did. I did a sport during 15 years.
What was the sport?
15 years.
Wrestling.
No kidding. Are you a wrestler?
Yes.
Wow. Oh my, but you said 15 years. You look so young. Oh my God.
I'm 28.
Oh.
I've been... 3 years I didn't practice.
Oh. Oh, but you did wrestling. Amazing. Did you ever participate in a tournament, like inside or outside El Salvador?
Yes, I participated in Codicader Games, in Central American Games, in Pan American Games.
Wow, that sounds amazing.
Yes, it was a good experience in my life.
Yes. Definitely yes, and please don't mess with Karina. Okay, don't mess with her. Are they medals? Why oh my medal? God, can you give us a tour really quick? Wow, those are all your medals.
Yeah, that's the Central American.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. Yeah.
How many medals do you have?
Yes.
Congratulations.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, that's amazing. How many medals? Have you ever counted the medals?
No, I think 100.
100.
Oh my goodness. Congrats.
So, yeah. Karina only need to learn the English and
but I started before when I was
how old were you?
Sorry?
How old were you? Sorry?
I am 28.
No, when you 28. Started, like when you started.
No? 9 years old.
Nine years old. Wow. Okay. Guys, do you know what wrestling is?
Why is wrestling?
Wrestling? No. Okay. No. So can you explain what you do? What you did? can you explain the sport a little bit?
It's similar a judo. It's like a fight with other girls in a weighting category.
Mm-hmm.
The most common when I won was put the back on the mat.
Okay, yeah, like turning, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Wow, yeah.
It's on a circle and use a close blue and red.
Wow, thank you so much for explaining that over. That yes. sounds great. So wrestling, there is a movie actually. There is, I don't remember the movie's name, but there is an Afghan guy. I'm going to try to remember the movie because aprendí de wrestling. I learned from
that movie. Yes, it's a good sport. I never imagined I practiced that because I liked gymnasts or swimming. Mm-hmm. I liked
wow.
But my parents didn't give me all support because they work.
Oh, okay.
And then at school, the federation have an, I don't know, exhibition.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and you liked it.
And I like the gymnasts, the la gimnasia.
Yes, I like the gymnastics. Wow. Okay.
Uh-huh. And then I learned the technique.
Wow.
And I continue.
Amazing. So guys, don't mess with Karina. Okay. So wrestling is what we call in Spanish lucha, right? Or yeah. Olympic wrestling. All right. So cool. Wow, that's amazing. Sounds definitely great. All right. Next one, guys, says being able to play a musical instrument is one of my dreams. Who says yes for this? I know that Rene and Alex, they play musical instruments. Anybody else plays musical instruments, or do you want to learn to play a musical instrument? Nobody?
I would like to
Which
play.
Which one, Clary?
Yes, I would like to play, how do you say violin?
Violin?
Violin.
Oh, the violin. Okay. Have you ever tried?
What?
Have you ever tried? Have you ever tried to play? Or have you gone to classes?
Oh, no, no. This is my dream.
Okay, that's your dream.
Oh, your dream.
Yes.
But you can start going to classes, my friend. Okay. Now my dream is to play the guitar, you know. But I have tried two times and it's difficult. Okay.
I am teacher.
Oh, can you play the guitar?
Yes.
Wow,
no,
nice.
No teacher.
But you know how to play the guitar.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Guys, can you play the guitar? Claudia, can you play musical instruments?
Electrical.
Electrical is more difficult. No?
Yeah.
No, teacher.
All right. Carlos, do you play musical instruments? No?
No.
Nothing? All right. I tried the guitar, but it's difficult. So my hands were like, you know, it was super difficult. Okay. Next one, guys. I was able to get up this morning without any problems. Sometimes, ya la edad pesa, you know. So take a look at this. I was able to get up this morning. Yo me pude levantar sin que me crujiera algo. Is that a yes for you or a no? Yes.
Yes.
No.
Yes. Yes.
No. Today morning? No. My butt hurts.
No.
So my back hurts a lot. I did exercise yesterday, y creo que fue mucho. So my back was like, oh, you know, that's enough for me. Is that a yes for you or a no? ¿Se levantaron bien sin que les crujiera algo?
Yes.
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 Okay. Okay, cool.
A drink of spiritual water.
Okay, next one. I have never really been able to understand movies in English. True or false? Yes or no? I have never really been able to understand. Nunca he podido, you know, understand movies in English. True?
I understand the Red Ryan and Rye in English anymore.
The movie?
No.
Yes.
Oh, nice.
I listen every night. El cuento, ¿verdad? El cuento. I listen every night. The Red Ryan and Rye every night.
Wait, the Red Riding Hood? What is the name of the story? Se me fue Alex. Alex, you're gone. What is the name of the story?
Yes, the Three Little Pigs.
The Three Little Pigs. Great. Okay. Oh, that's a very good practice, guys. Very good practice. So, escuchen cuentos, listen to stories for kids, y repítanlas, repeat it until you get it. Nice.
Es que van bien lento, teacher. Yes. Entonces uno logra entender.
Mm-hmm. That's true. La Caperucita Roja, The Little Red Riding Hood, The Three Little Pigs, Snow White. Very good practice. Hey, that's a very nice one. Creo que vamos a implementarla. We're going to implement it. Okay, nice.
The opera.
All right. Opera.
Yeah. The Ghost.
Oh, the movie. Okay. Yeah. Okay, nice. The next one says, I would love to be able to cook like a professional. Is this a yes or a no? Can you cook? I would love to be able. Be able, no le pongan atención. Es solamente like, me gustaría aprender. I would love to be able to cook like a professional, yes or no?
Yes.
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 I would like to cook.
You would like. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. Cool. Yes. Cool. Cool. Nice. Nice. And the last one, my parents cannot speak English as well as me. Can your parents speak English?
No.
No?
No. No.
Your brothers? Your sisters?
No.
No. Only my son.
Only your son. Okay. Oh, but you have family. Tiene con quien practicar. So you can practice with him.
My
cousins. Okay. My daughter. Your cousins. Your daughter. Wow. Yeah. How old is your daughter?
6.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Now that's beautiful. Because yeah. Cuando están pequeñitos agarran la mejor entonación, you know? The best intonation ever. Okay, cool. So, hablemos un poquito about your abilities. ¿Qué pueden hacer? What can you do? Let's take a look at the following. Respond to questions regarding qualifications and potential contributions. So, first, tenemos André y tenemos Ben. Claudia, no la he escuchado today. Quiero escuchar su voz. I want to listen to your voice. Ayúdame con André, por favor. No es necesario que diga hello, Ben. Le puede cambiar el nombre. That's okay. And ¿quiénes tienen la cámara apagada? Wait, let me go with some victims. ¿Eduardo? ¿Está por ahí, Eduardo? Edward. Maybe not. Richard, ayúdame con Ben. Help me out with Ben. Ya vi su micrófono, así que let's do it.
Okay.
So, Claudia, you can start.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you. Meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
I can speak English also. I can manage small and big projects. I am very good at selling.
That's on great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using speaking, ¿cómo se pronuncia esa teacher? Speeches?
Mm-hmm, that's right. That's a speech.
Speaking. Mm-hmm. Can you use them?
I can speak like a Chinese, but I can't use it. Speech.
British.
Mm-hmm. But I am a fast learner.
Mm-hmm. I heard it.
Get it.
Can you get it? When can you start?
Amazing. Thank you so much, guys. Very good. I want you to pay attention to this. Guys, ¿alguien ha estado en una entrevista de trabajo en inglés? Have you ever been in a job interview in English?
No.
Never? Yeah. Nobody?
No.
¿O algún tipo de entrevista? Have you ever been in any interview? Pero en inglés, right? In English?
Yes.
Carlos.
I was in interview. In English.
Ooh, how was the experience?
It's very difficult, but some words I don't know. And when the other people make the answer.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The question.
Okay.
Sometimes I don't know what to say.
Okay. So the question was not very clear for you.
Yes.
Got it.
Yes, or use words that I don't know.
Okay. Very nice. And thank you for bringing this. Because, for example, the word qualification suena como cualificación, como una nota, right? Como una calificación. But actually, no. A qualification is, ¿qué puede hacer? What can you do? We are talking about your abilities. But in a job interview, it is very common they ask you this question. What qualifications do you have for the job? In other words, ¿qué puede hacer? What can you do? Okay. So Carlos was in a job interview. ¿Quién más ha estado en una job interview in English? Nobody?
No.
alguna vez, have you ever talked to a person in English?
Yes, teacher.
No, you have. Not yet. Todavía no. Not yet. Okay. Got it.
The last time, teacher, I was on the conference with the people of the corporation, the U.S. and Czech Republic.
Okay, I remember you mentioned that you had conferences in English. I do remember that.
In my case, I only listen to the conversation, and my boss is the
encargado. The one who speaks. The one in charge.
Uh-huh, in charge or responsible to speak with them.
Got it. All right. So today, guys, or this module, let's say, vamos a prepararnos para una job interview. Okay, so we are going to, vamos a repasar, vamos a practicar preguntas that people normally ask you in a job interview. And of course, ¿cuál es la forma más adecuada de responderlas? How I can answer to that job interview. ¿Qué me pueden preguntar? And how I can answer it. To be honest with you, normally I have job interviews in English, or I have, you know, interview people in English. No es tan difícil, but the thing is that most of the times, quieren saber su nivel de inglés. They are not asking you questions por la respuesta, sino porque quieren saber cómo ustedes responden. How you answer, qué tan seguros están, how your pronunciation goes. Si pueden especialmente utilizar pasados, you know, because past is really hard. So, those are the little things that they do. So, la primera pregunta que vamos a practicar ahora is this. What qualifications do you have for this job? ¿Qué pueden hacer? What can you do for my company? Okay. So, espero que algún día, someday, muy pronto, you have the opportunity to have an interview in English, and it's going to be like, yo vi esto, y yo sé cómo responderle. So, I really hope les pueda ayudar, you know, probably to get a job, probably to get a promotion in your job, or simplemente si aplican a una beca, you know, they will ask you also these type of questions. So, let's get started. First, the person says, well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects. And I am very good at sales. Se está vendiendo. The person is selling himself. Yeah. Can you speak Chinese? The person says, I can speak little, right? No, dice que no, dice que un poquito. I can speak little Chinese, but I cannot use a spreadsheet. I want you to take a look at the following. Dice que no lo puede usar, pero no dice como, no puedo. Dice, I cannot use a spreadsheet, but I am a fast learner, yeah? No puedo, pero aprendo rápido, okay? It's like, I cannot do it, pero deme la oportunidad, but give me the opportunity to learn, right? So, vamos a vendernos, guys. You're going to sell ourselves, especially with this question. Before getting started, before checking this out, I have just some questions here. Vamos a revisar un poquito el can, pero no, yo sé que ya lo manejan, I know you know it, no es algo nuevo, entonces solamente practiquemos la pronunciación. Number one, I want you to help me. Quiero que me ayuden a leer la primera. ¿Cuál es la diferencia de negativos y positivos? Because when I'm talking, especialmente cuando hablan rápido, right? No se escucha la T. You don't listen. I can't speak English. No se oye. Entonces, ¿cuál va a ser la diferencia? How can I make the difference between positive sentences and negative sentences? Let's talk about abilities. ¿Qué pueden hacer, guys? I can use... ¿Qué máquinas pueden usar? What machines can you use?
The printer.
I can use a fork.
No puedo usarlo. I cannot use a fork. Okay. A forklift, right? Okay. I can use computer. ¿Algo más específico de la computadora?
I can't use the Excel program.
I mean, neither. Okay. Yeah, that's so bad. Yes?
I can use the data logger.
lawyer. How do you spell lawyer? Like lawyer de abogado? O lawyer?
Lawyer, lawyer.
The how do you lawyer. Can you spell that for me?
To sign the data of the groundwater.
Is this the word, lawyer?
No, lawyer.
Con doble lawyer. Teacher.
No, 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 no. L-O-G-G-E-R-R.
Like this? Why? No. Why?
G-G-G-G.
Oh, G-G. A logger.
Yeah, yeah.
Not a logger.
Not a lawyer. Okay.
Oh, okay. Okay. I didn't know. All right. Thank you. So let's take a look at this. Tengo negative and I have positive sentences too. Now, I need your help with this. ¿Cómo leo el primero? How do you read number one?
I can use a printer.
Necesito que busquen una palabra, ¿ya? Y me la enfaticen a little bit. En las positivas, voy a enfatizar, es decir, va a sonar más fuerte el verbo. So, in this one, quiero que se escuche un poco más fuerte la palabra use. Can you do it?
Okay.
I can use a printer.
Okay, Moses?
I can use a printer.
Mm-hmm. Claudia?
I can use a printer.
Okay, very good, very good. Ahora unámoslo todo. Que se oiga como más seguido. La misma entonación, very good intonation, solo seguido.
I can use a printer.
Okay, okay, much better. Dolores? Dolores. Se me fue Dolores. Nice. Guadalupe?
I can use a printer.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Ignacio?
I can use a printer.
Okay, very good. La siguiente, negative. Negative sentences, el verbo se escucha menos. El que se utiliza más o el que escucha más va a ser el negativo. Can't. I can't. Yeah? So suben el sonido y luego lo bajan otra vez. Now let's do it. Norberto, number two.
I can use a forklift.
Forklift. Okay, forklift. One more time. Solo que le escuché la palabra use más fuerte. Enfaticemos el can. I can use.
I can use a forklift.
One more time, un poco más fuerte.
I can use a forklift.
Me enfatiza el use. Me le está diciendo positiva. One more time. I can use.
I can use a forklift.
Mm-hmm, much better, exactly. So I can use. So what we do is positive sentences, se escucha el verbo. Negative sentences, se escucha el can't, right? Let's do it together, guys. Let's do it together. Number one, I can use a printer.
I can use a printer.
Okay, now negative. Number two, I can use a forklift.
I can use a forklift.
There we go. Pedrina?
I can use a forklift.
One more time, todo junto. I can use.
I can use a forklift.
Uh-huh, very good. Nelson?
I can use a forklift.
Un poquito más fuerte. I can use.
I can use a forklift.
I can use a forklift.
Exactly. Norbert, you got it. Very good. So it's, no es como que lo separemos los sonidos. Solo subimos el tono de voz. I can use, right? No escucho la T, pero sí hago la diferencia que es negativa. Number three. What about this one? ¿Quién me ayuda con esta? Who can help me with this?
I can use Excel very well.
One more time.
I can use.
Un poco más fuerte. I can use.
I can use Excel very well.
Very good. There we go. Yeah. Exactly. And the last one. So the last one is positiva. ¿Qué voy a enfatizar? What are we going to emphasize?
Use.
Exactly. ¿Cómo leemos la última? How do we read it?
I can use that a lot. Lower.
I can use. Yeah. Mabel?
I can use.
Exactly. So if you pay attention, la T casi no se escucha, but this is what it works. Yeah. So this is the difference. Now help me with this. Karina, please. How do you read this one?
Okay. I can speak three language.
Okay. Un poco más cerca y enfatíceme el speak.
Okay. I can I can speak three languages.
Okay, very good. Solo que no me lo separe, un poco más cerca. One more time.
I can speak three languages.
There we go. Very good. Exactly. Next one. Next. Clary?
Two?
This one.
Okay. I can do small projects.
Very good. Exactly. Negative. Carlos? This one.
I can use a spreadsheet, but learn fast.
Mm-hmm. Very good. There we go. And the next one, Richard.
Hello. Sorry. And the question?
Ayúdame con esta. Solo léame esta.
Okay. I can use this program, but I am a fast learner.
Mm-hmm. Very good, there we go. So, I can use, right? Esa palabra suena como con un poquito de vibración. Use, I can use, right? Very good, guys. Very good. Now, help me with this. It says, complete the sentences with the appropriate form of can. Como estamos escuchando, vamos a tener que educar el oído para saber si es positiva o negativa. So, number one, I'm sorry, I help you today, I'm really busy. ¿Qué me ayuda con la primera? Enfatizando ya sea el can't o el help. Si es positiva o es negativa, right? Number one. Who wants to read number one?
Me, teacher.
Yes, go, Danis.
Okay.
I can't.
I am sorry. I can't hear you today. I am really busy.
Very good. Exactly. Jocelyn, number two. Help us with two.
I am always like.
Okay, good. Solo una cosita. La escuché positiva. I heard it positive. It's negative. So, I mean, your sentence is good. Good. Solamente enfatice un poquito más la negativa.
Mm-hmm. I am always.
Very nice. Exactly. So I just can't manage to wake up on time. Mm-hmm. Very good. Number three. Who has number three? Jackie? Hi, Jackie. Good evening. So happy to see you there. Hi, Brenda. Creo que Brenda dijo que iba a poner más atención, right? Ya la voy a molestar.
No, como estaba diciendo Jackie.
Solo estoy molestándole, but help me, ya que está por ahí, help me with number three. Ayúdeme con la tercera, por favor.
Look, it is right there. No. Look, it is right there. Y tengo que completarla.
Sí, ¿con positiva o negativa? Can or can't?
De la tía Evelyn.
Guys, pueden ayudar. You can help.
Can you see this? It's so old.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I can't.
Mm-hmm. So look, it's right there. Exactly. And this is negative, right? So enfatizamos el can. Can you see it? Can. Right? Can you see it? Mm-hmm. It's obvious. There we go. Eduardo, number four, please.
I speak German. I live in Germany for 8 years.
Thank you. Could you please repeat the first sentence?
Speak.
I think, I'm sorry, you were cut off. So, se le cortó un poquito. Tell me. o no sé si es mi mute. I think I'm cutting off. Guys, me estoy cortando. Am I cutting?
No.
Not breaking.
Oh. I couldn't hear that. Okay.
I can speak Germany. I live in Germany for 8 years.
Perfect. Okay. I can speak German. Exactly. Very good. Thank you, Claudia. Hey, number five. Who's got number five? She doesn't have a driver's license. She can drive can or she drive. Can drive. ¿Cuál de las dos?
She can drive.
Yes, she can drive. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Aunque no escuche la P, lo puedo saber que dijo sí o no just by listening to that pronunciation. Okay, guys, very good. So here we have the following activity. I have this vocabulary for you. Okay. So vamos a repetirlo. We are going to repeat it. Porque ellos nos van a ayudar para hablar de nuestras strengths, de nuestras fortalezas. And remember, today's question is, what are your qualifications or what are your strengths? Vamos a hablar de qué es lo que usted le aporta a la empresa. Please repeat with me. Attentive.
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 Detail oriented. Detail
oriented.
Detail oriented.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Who is a detail oriented? Una persona bien meticulosa, right? Que le pone atención al detalle. Are you detail oriented? Yo no. Not me.
Thank you.
Are you detail oriented?
Yes.
So meticuloso. Are you very meticulous?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Wow, nice. Next one, let's repeat it. Collaborative.
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 Next one, committed.
Committed.
What is the meaning of commitment?
Compromiso.
Compromiso. So what is committed?
Yes.
Comprometido. Exactly.
Yes.
So if I ask you, what are your qualifications for the job? Or you can say, soy una persona bien comprometida con mi trabajo. I am very committed to my job. Yo puedo hacer esto. I can do this, right? So that's committed. Next one, dedicated.
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 Mm-hmm. Next, creative.
Creative.
Okay, vamos a repetirlo.
Creative.
Puedo pronunciarle de dos formas. Creative or creative.
Creative.
Que vibre el labio. Al final, creative.
Creative.
Jocelyn.
Creative.
Guadalupe.
Creative.
Norbert.
Creative.
Very good. There we go. Exactly. Next one. Disciplined.
Discipline.
Mm-hmm. Next.
Discipline.
Focus. Focus.
Focus.
Focus.
Focus.
Focus.
Focus.
Focus.
Focus. Nice. Escuché por ahí una T. Very good. Focused. Okay. Focus. Next one. Focus. Empathetic.
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 Empathetic. Are you empathetic? ¿Son empáticos?
Yes.
Are you empathetic? So, yes. Y ahí es donde viene y dicen cuáles son sus habilidades. I am very empathetic. Yo puedo escuchar a las personas. You know, I can listen to people and understand their problems. So that's what we combine. Next one, enthusiastic.
Enthusiastic.
Passionate.
Passionate.
Driven.
Driven.
So what is this? Es lo mismo. Y si alguna vez ven una palabra like passionate, no es solo en un sentido romántico, ¿ok? So in your work, you can be passionate. And what is that? Que son como, les encanta lo que hacen, right? That you really like what you do. So driven, yeah. Enthusiastic, and passionate. Next one, flexible.
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 Mm-hmm. Next, honest.
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 Next one, innovative.
Innovative.
Very good. Innovative. Next one, patient.
Patient.
Patient. Pero suave, no fuerte como patient, no, es un poco más suave. Patient.
Patient.
Okay. Next. Respectful.
Respectful.
Very good. Now, guys, these are strengths. Estas son fortalezas. These are really good things about each of you. What I want you to do is now, de la lista, seleccionen las que aplican para ustedes. Select the ones that are good for you, right? For example, dice el orienter, yo no soy así como me fijo en una comita, you know? I cannot be that way. Pero si hay personas que son bien delicadas, bien meticulosas, y es súper genial, you know? Because not everybody can do it. So, yes. select the ones that apply to you, right? And me dicen cuando las tengan listas. Probably 3, 4, 5. So, seleccionen las que aplican. Select the ones. I don't think so. pero si todas aplican mejor, porque va a hablar más, you're going to practice more. Yo les digo lo que van a hacer. I'll let you know what you
do. One.
No, not anymore. I don't think so. Select them, guys. Okay. I'll give you 1 minute. Si tienen preguntas con el significado de algunas, let me know. Me avisan, please.
Now. Miss Julia.
Yes, tell me.
Creative in next. How do you say pronunciation? Determined.
Determined.
Okay.
Yes, determined.
Respectful is respetuoso.
Yes, respectfully.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Ready? Is everybody ready? ¿Ya seleccionaron? Did you select some?
Yes.
Okay, sure. I'll give you
30
seconds. Yes,
please.
Norbert.
Many. ¿Cuántos?
Ah, how many? Okay, no le escuché el how. Wesley. Okay. Well, I would say 3, 4, pero si considera que 10 de estas aplican, dele. It's totally good. I don't have any problem with that.
Okay, thank you.
I'm okay with it. All right.
Passionate, patient, respectful, patient, respectful.
Yes. Yes?
I have my three strength.
Oh, okay. Hold it, please. Hold it just a second. Wait a minute. Ahorita les digo qué vamos a hacer. Okay. So, si ya tenemos las strengths, if you are ready with them, let's go ahead and check the following. I have this question at the very beginning. What are your abilities or strengths? Okay. This is a key question. Esa es la pregunta que siempre nos hacen en a job interview. And as Carlos said before, tal vez no con estas palabras, pero siempre le van a preguntar. Dígame 3 cosas buenas de usted, you know? Dígame por qué lo debo de contratar. So, this is your opportunity, guys, to sell yourself, okay? Y qué más que practicar ahorita to answer this question. I will give you, les voy a dar exactamente 4 minutes. I'll give you 4 minutes para que se contesten esta pregunta. What are your abilities or strengths? ¿Qué pueden hacer? What can you do? All right. ¿Y cuáles son sus fortalezas? Here, la persona le preguntó, what qualifications do you have for the job? Y él le respondió, yo puedo hacer esto. I can speak English. Also, I can manage projects. I am a fast learner. Yo aprendo rápido, que es una strength. No la tenemos en la lista, pero también es una strength. Y usted puede ahí aprovechar y venderse. I am detail oriented. I pay attention to every single detail in a report. Or I am very patient. People can scream at me and I don't react. I am not aggressive, etc. So, tienen 4 minutitos. You got 4 minutes para pensar cómo puedo responder esa pregunta. How can I answer this question? What are your abilities or strengths? ¿Qué pueden hacer? What can you do? La pueden escribir, you can write it down, pueden tomar notas, you can take notes. Y luego vamos a escucharlos. We are going to listen to you. Un breve comercial. Anita, tenemos one on one. So, si me regalan unos minutitos a ti antes. Thank you.
Okay. Voy a apagarlo.
Me tocó echar el aceite porque no me movía, ¿no?
One more minute. Okay, time is over. Okay, everybody, listen up. This is going to be, esta es una de las primeras preguntas de las muchas que vamos a revisar en unit number one. Little by little, vamos a ir agregando más preguntas como tell me about yourself, cuéntame de su último empleo, etcétera, etcétera. So, what we are going to do is the following. Of course, I want to listen to you guys as much as possible, pero ya que somos varios, vamos a hacerlo, you know, con time limited. So, this is going to be your homework for tomorrow. For tomorrow, deben de preparar una presentación súper bonita, you know. When I say presentation, no es de 5 o 10 minutos, es de 30 segundos. In 30 seconds, deben de hablarnos de sus habilidades and your strengths, right? But, super fluido, like in a very fluent way, ¿ya? Sin detenerse, without stops. So, comienzan a hablar y si se les olvida algo, agreguen palabras como let me think, let me see, I don't remember, wait a minute. La idea es no detenerse, not to stop. But, necesito dos voluntarios. I just need two volunteers. Alguien que quiera hacerlo ahorita, somebody who wants to volunteer and do it today. Así ya no lo tiene pendiente para mañana.
I teach.
Oh, nice. I like it. We do have volunteers.
Hay que darle prisa.
No, no, Richard. Bye, Richard. Let us listen to you. So remember, this is the opportunity. Pensemos en una job interview, en a real job interview. O imagínense que va a aplicar, I don't know, en un empleo, en el consulado or something like that. So, what are your abilities? What are your strengths? Vende a Richard, sell yourself.
Okay, listen. My case, collaborative, attentive, creativity, empathic,
okay.
Restful.
Responsible? Or respectful, sorry.
Respectful.
Okay, you're very respectful.
Yes, determination.
Determined. Okay, Richard, what are your abilities?
Ability, creative.
Okay. With abilities, podemos utilizar el can. I can.
Ah, okay. I can. Cuando es positivo, I can. Creative. And work. You know.
You're doing a very nice job. Okay, solo trabajemos en la parte de Ken, but very good job with the strength. Super bien con las fortalezas. Very good. Pero lo hizo super bien. You did it nicely. Yeah, solo agregamos como qué es lo que puede hacer. Oh, I can fix things. Puedo arreglar cosas. I can find solutions easily. So pensemos en todas sus habilidades. Destruir, construir, I can build,
yes.
Not destroy, yes. Okay. Escuché a Carlos, I heard Carlos too. Carlos, are you ready?
Yes.
Perfect, I have a minute for you, go.
1 minute.
No, 30 segundos, 30 seconds.
Okay. Okay, I am working in the PC, I use Excel, to make reports and cardex and all of the relationship with storage. I make a schedule to import in traffic of container, and I can adaptable. How do you say adaptable?
I am flexible. I can adapt.
I can adapt to the many circumstances, and I love learn different topics every day.
Very nice. Amazing. Guys, emojis for Carlos. That was very nice. That was a very good description. Good. Denle emojis, guys. No le puedo dar emojis acá. I cannot give you emojis here. Wait. I see Karina's hand up. Okay, so Karina, let's go for you. I think we got 30 seconds. So let's do it, Karina.
That is the emoji.
Ah, pensé que era la mano. I thought you were raising your hand.
No, 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 no. Okay, okay, okay. Good evening. My name is Karina, and I'm talking about myself. I consider I am a respectful person, and I like to work in a team. I like to be a enthusiastic person during the work, and if I have a problem, I try to resolve. I am a collaborative person and really committed with my work.
Amazing. Hey, that was beautiful. Very nice description. Good, good, good. Guys, give some love, give some emojis. No tenemos aplausos, but you can also give emojis. Okay, sorry, there you teacher. Go. Yes, Ignacio. Ignacio, I'm sorry. I have to cut you off because of the time. Solo me queda para attendance. Pero no se preocupe that tomorrow you will be my first person with this. I promise you'll be my first. So guys, ¿cuál es la tarea para mañana? What is your homework? Carlos, we are good. Karina, we are good. Los demás tienen tarea. Okay, your homework is preparar 30 segundos, you know, your answer, es más que todo la respuesta a esta pregunta. What are your abilities or what are your strengths? So, lo que pueden hacer, what you can do, y también venderse, right? In a way, I am very committed, I can do this, I can do that. I am very respectful, I can respect people, no matter religion, no matter race, etc. Invéntense la respuesta, you know, but something important, trabajemos con su fluidez. De ser posible, grábense respondiendo la pregunta y ustedes pregúntense, ¿verdad? Evalúense. Me entiendo, me entendí, ¿ok? Y si no, pues vuélvanlo a hacer, do it again. Si hay palabras que no saben cómo pronunciarlas, vayan a Google, vayan a YouTube. No les digo, pongan su texto de español a inglés, there, sino pongan la palabra y escuchen cómo se pronuncia para poder repetirla, right? So, we will do it by tomorrow. That is going to be tomorrow. Y tomorrow vamos a tener un par de voluntarios. Vamos a seguir, you know, vamos a agregar every single day más preguntas hasta que el último día de la unidad, pues estemos listos para tener una job interview, como algo real. Con los nervios, you know, el miedo and everything of a job interview. So hopefully we can do it. Chicos, se nos acabó el tiempo. Time runs super, super fast. So solo nos queda, voy a pasar asistencia. I'm going to check attendance really quick. Si me ayudan con su camarita, please help me out with your camera. Just a little bit. Gracias a todos por estar acá bien tempranito, super, super early. Tenemos asistencia casi perfecta, almost perfect. So thank you so much for that. Yes. Delmi, me confirma porfa, me regala confirmación.
Present, teacher.
Ahí está, Delmi. Thank you. Brian.
Present.
Oh, there you go. Thank you so much, Brian. I don't see Anthony. Danis.
Present.
Dolores.
Hi, Danis.
Present.
Eduardo.
Present.
Thank you so much. Guadalupe.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jackie. Wait, I see her there. Jocelyn?
I'm here.
Thank you. Ignacio?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Norbert?
Present.
Marvin? Wait, Alex. Siempre me voy con Marvin. Well, ahí está Marvin. Clary?
Hello, Miss. I am
Gracias,
present.
Gracias, Miss. Thank you so much. Moses?
Present.
Thank you. Nelson?
Present.
Thank you so much. Pedrina?
Present, teacher.
Thank you, René. Thank you so much. Richard.
Present, teacher.
Mabel.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Brenda.
Present, teacher.
Carlos.
Present.
Claudia.
Present, teacher.
And Karina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Wow, amazing. Okay. Okay, everybody. So thank you so much. Gracias por estar super activos in today's class. Thank you for your participation. En la plataforma, ya les tendré, ya me confirman porfa en el grupo si alguien tiene dificultades con el acceso. Si alguien no se lo han activado todavía, let me know para poder darle el seguimiento, right? Nos vemos el día de mañana. I'll be seeing you. Oh, permítame, solo les tomo la foto. Wait, don't go. No. Please don't go. Okay, so just help me with your camera a little bit.
Yes.
Let me take the picture of day number one. And, okay, Brian, gracias por el emoji. Ahí está. Okay, amazing. Ahora sí, guys. Thank you so much. Nos vemos mañana. I'll be seeing you tomorrow. Anita, me regalo unos minutos, please. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
See you. Bye. See you. Denme unos segunditos. Anita. Bye, ya se fueron. Okay, gracias Anita, thank you so much for being here. Me alegro mucho verla. I'm super excited to see you. How are you, miss? ¿Cómo está? ¿Cómo se siente?
Fine, very fine.
Good.
And enjoy and happy. The course.
Nice. Okay. At the beginning of the class, estuvimos hablando de commitments. Como un compromiso personal, you know, no conmigo, right? No con el curso, sino con usted. Something that you say, este módulo 6, lo quiero lograr. I want to do it. So I asked these guys que los escribieran. So this is why in the chat, they were writing like, voy a aprenderme dos palabras. I'm going to learn two words. I'm going to participate more in classes. I'm going to be on time. So first, I would like to know, what is your personal commitment? What is your goal? ¿Cuál es la meta for this specific module? To be honest with you, siento que me ha dado pasos gigantes. I feel that you are moving forward a lot. The previous module, sentí que avanzó, but like incredibly nice. You were speaking more, participating more. No le vi mucho escribir, sino que ya pensándolo, thinking and answering. So that's amazing. So I have really big expectations for you. So tell me, what is your expectation for this module? What do you want to do for this module?
My expectation for the module are more practice.
Okay.
And I learn word, new words.
Okay.
And verbs.
Okay. How many do you plan? How many words or how many verbs do you plan to learn every day? Like a realistic plan. Something realistic.
Two words.
Two. Okay.
Two
good.
Words for day.
Ajá, exactly. Okay, amazing. So se las pregunto mañana. I will ask you the words tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay. Today, we were practicing this topic of tell me about your abilities, tell me about your strength. So I think we can use this opportunity, the one-on-one, to listen to you. What are your abilities or what are your strengths? What can you do?
My strong are tentative and collaborate, communicate,
committed, like comprometida, committed,
committed.
Ah, okay, okay, good.
And respectful.
Oh, okay, very good. Now, what can you do? What are your abilities?
I can use the computer.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Program system.
Okay.
And I use I drive the car.
Okay. Are you a system engineer? Yeah, right.
My career is licenciatura en sistemas.
Oh, you have a BA. Okay, great. So this is your opportunity para que se venda. Imagínese que you are applying for a job en su área, right? In your area of expertise. So ¿cómo se vendería? Talking about your qualifications, what can you do? Hablando de computadoras, you know, programs, etc. Can you program?
No, teacher. My work is very different. My career. And not practice my career.
Okay. So what can you do? Like in a very general way. Maybe you don't practice your career, pero sí puede hacer algunas cosas. I mean, yo sé que la tecnología cambia like this, pero sí puede hacer algunas cosas. Todavía se recuerda, right? How to do some things from your career.
And yes, I create a web page.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And program very little.
Okay.
And formulas. No sé si así se dice formulas.
Yeah, formulas.
Formulas de Excel.
Oh, you can use, you can say something like, I can use Excel very well.
Yes.
Eso es importante. That's important. And Excel yes. is very difficult.
In so, the actually, yes, very important.
Yes. So you can use Excel. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Only teacher.
Talking about your job, you mentioned that your job is different from your career. So talking about your job, what is important? ¿Qué es lo que puede hacer, like, super bien de su trabajo in your job?
¿Cómo se dice manejo del programa?
I manage
the very well. I have 10 years in my job.
Sorry to interrupt. ¿Cuál es el programa que maneja? What do you manage?
Fíjese que se llama Open. Y ahí se hace de todo, pues.
Okay, but véndame eso. Ajá, so sell that to me. So I manage the program that is called Open. Mm-hmm.
I manage the program, the Open, very, very well. I create clients. ¿Cómo le puedo decir? Como la información de los clientes. Pasarla de una cuenta a otra.
Usted maneja. You can say, I manipulate information.
I manipulate information that consume the energy the clients.
Okay.
I need annulation the bill. The bill.
I mistake
in the lectura.
In the reading,
I annulation.
You delete the bill.
I delete
or you void.
The bill.
Hay una palabra. Let me share that with you. Hay una palabra que creo que nos puede ayudar para esto. Se llama void. Ah, si la logro ver en el chat. Sí, void es anular. Como, por ejemplo, hay un pago, pero hubo un error en el pago, entonces esa factura se anula. En inglés se le llama void.
Ah, void, anulación.
Uh-huh. Yes. Tipo so you voided. Ajá, yes.
Yes.
You voided. Ah, ok. So, si no me equivoco, open es como una database, como una base de datos, right?
Yes.
Así suena.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So, Dilby, esas son las habilidades que usted tiene. Those are your abilities. Venda eso. Sell that over to you because that's important. You know, little things, cosas que uno le ve como ya las da por sentadas, you know, le pueden dar un plus because you use open. Yo no tengo ni idea qué es, you know. I have no idea what it is. So sell that over, right? So tareita va a ser, you know, this one, piensa, haga como un estudio de todo lo que hace. Okay, ¿qué es lo que yo hago? What do I do? What can I do? Practice it, yeah, para que se sienta más cómoda with this. Yo sé que ahorita es como, Dios santo, ¿cómo se dicen tantas cosas?
Yes,
porque teacher. El vocabulario es bien rebuscado, pero lo hice súper bien. You did it super nicely. So, nos vemos el día de mañana. Gracias por conectarse. Thank you so much for being here.
You're welcome.
Nos vemos mañana. I'll be seeing you tomorrow. Have a good night.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
See you.
Tomorrow.
Yes.
And tell me, si le quiero pedir un enorme favor, I want to ask you for a big favor.
Dígame.